Good morning, children. Welcome back to our Google Classroom. Today, we will discuss the textual activities of the lesson, A Bicycle in Good Repair. Page number 133, Working with Language. First one, read the following sentences. We should go for a long bicycle ride. I ought to have been firm. You mustn't lose any of them. I suggested that he should hold the fork and that I should handle the wheel. The words in italics are modal auxiliaries. Modal auxiliaries are used with verbs to express notions such as possibility, permission, willingness, obligation, necessity, etc. Should, must, and ought to generally express moral obligation, necessity, and desirability. Look at the following. We should go on a holiday. Suggestion. Here, it is a good idea for us to go on a holiday. He is not too well these days. He must see a doctor before he becomes worse. Compulsion or necessity. It is absolutely essential or necessary for him to see a doctor. You ought to listen to me. I am well over a decade older than you. More emphatic than should. Since I am older than you, it is advisable that you listen to me. Note, should and ought to are often used interchangeably. Rewrite each of the following sentences using should or ought to or must in place of the italicized words. Make other changes wherever necessary. First one, you are obliged to do your duty irrespective of consequences. So, what is the answer? You ought to do your duty irrespective of consequences. Second one, you will do well to study at least for an hour every day. What is the answer? You should study at least for an hour every day. Third one, the doctor says it is necessary for her to sleep 8 hours every night. The answer is, the doctor says she must sleep 8 hours every night. Fourth one, it is right that you show respect towards elders and affection towards youngsters. The answer is, you ought to show respect towards elders and affection towards youngsters. Fifth one, if you want to stay healthy, exercise regularly. The answer is, you should exercise regularly to stay healthy. Number 6, it is good for you to take a walk every morning. The answer is, you should take a walk every morning. 7, it is strongly advised that you don't stand on your head. The answer is, you must not stand on your head. Number 8, as he has a cold, it is better for him to go to bed. The answer is, as he has a cold, he should go to bed. Page number 135. Number 2. Use should or must or ought to appropriately in the following sentences. First one. People who live in glass houses dash not throw stones. What is the answer? People who live in glass houses should not throw stones. Second one. You dash wipe your feet before coming into the house, especially during the rains. The answer is, you must wipe your feet before coming into the house, especially during the rains. Third one, you dash do what the teacher tells you. You must do what the teacher tells you. Number 4, the pupils were told that they dash write more neatly. The pupils were told that they should write more neatly. Number 5. Sign in front of a park. You dash not walk on the grass. Sign in front of a park. You must not walk on the grass. Number 6. You dash be ashamed of yourself having made such a remark. You ought to be ashamed of yourself having made such a remark. Number 7. He left home at 9 o'clock. He dash be here any minute. He left home at 9 o'clock. He should be here any minute. Number 8. Whatever happened to the chocolate cake? How dash I know? I have just arrived. Whatever happened to the chocolate cake? How should I know? I have just arrived. Number 3. Two or more single sentences can be combined to form a single sentence. Read the following. I made an effort and was pleased with myself. This sentence is in fact a combination of two sentences. First one, I made an effort, and second one, I was pleased with myself. Now, read this sentence. I did not see why he should shake it. This is also a combination of two sentences. First sentence, I did not see it. Second sentence, why should he shake it? Divide each of the following sentences into its parts. Write meaningful parts. If necessary, supply a word or two to make each part meaningful. First one, I went to the tool shed to see what I could find. We have to make it to three parts. First part, I went to the tool shed. Second part, I went there to see. Third part, what I could find. Find out the rest of the answers yourself. Page number 136. Number 4. En acts as a prefix, that means put at the beginning, or as a suffix, that means put at the end, to form new words. Example, en plus courage, encourage. Weak plus en, weaken. En at the beginning or at the end of a word is not always a prefix or a suffix. It is then an integral part of the word. For example, ending, barren. Now, arrange the words given in the box under the three headings, prefix, suffix, and part of the word. Do it yourself. Second one, find new words in your textbook and put them under the same headings. Find out the words yourself from the textbook. That's all for today. A YouTube URL is attached. Watch the video. A test paper is also included. Submit your answers as soon as possible. We can meet in the next class with a new topic. Thank you.